We'll be right back. life preparing to fall away from the parent world. From its own ashes, the phoenix first must burn.
Just got to butt in, talk a little bit about what we're listening to. So is this Kwaito?
Yeah, this is sort of like a modern day version of what Kwaito is at this point in time. But like there's like different versions, like variety of versions as well, like of modern day Kwaito. But I'll play a bit more like a bit more jams a bit later on.
Right, so you were saying this is like mid-tempo, is that right?
Yeah. This is kind of like the mid-tempo Kwaito sort of soundscape. Yeah. I put it very much like within the Kwaito.
Beautiful. It's got sort of like a garage sound to it, right?
Yeah. So it is sort of garage, but then the BPM is a bit lower than what garage usually is. So garage is mostly like 120 upwards. And this would be like around about 100 BPM to up until like 112, 113 at most.
Right, and you like know all the names of these tracks and everything? Like, well, you sort of know where these guys are from and stuff?
I mean, yeah, I try to do my research, especially when I come across like songs that I really like, that are really fun to me and stuff. So I try and like go into, apart from just having the track list on my playlist or whatever, but like I do like a bit of a research like sort of thing that I do. Yeah, just to get like some insight where like these guys are from, what inspires them and so forth. Yeah, sort of like
nice. Yeah, I mean, it's so important to keep community music alive and keep the culture alive, especially if it's like got new sound to it as well, something developing, something working with old sounds, old flavors. Yeah,
absolutely.
I'm looking forward to hearing the infusion, so we were just paying attention, like hearing this beat and hearing the Kwaito later on, hearing like the more traditional stuff from the 80s, and just we'll hear that mix coming together. Same sort of drums or just a similar sort of beat? Is that what we're thinking?
Very much similar across the board. Yeah, but this is practically like a merge of like the two genres, Kwaito and mid-tempo. Because they were predominantly around like within the same time, you know. There isn't Kwaito without mid-tempo, and there's no mid-tempo without Kwaito, basically, you know.
Cool, yeah, well, it's great to hear the South African sound. Oh, and beyond, I guess. Sorry. Okay, gotta jump in here. Who's this track?
Yeah, no, this gem right here belongs to a well-renowned DJ across the country, a guy by the name of Insert Points, who also happens to be part of the Bro Collective. Yeah, those gents are doing amazing stuff, bro. Apart from like music alone, but like merchandising, like in essence, bro. Like if you want to have a party, like anything you just mentioned, like bro, like they do it to that extent, like they do it to the core, bro. And yeah, you're bound to have a good time, like whenever you go to, especially they have this place called Bro Clubhouse. It's always happening, it's always going down there, man. Every flipping weekend, week in, week out, bro. Like
nice, I've heard about these guys, they're doing fashion as well, is that right? Yeah, they're going massive, and people lining up around the block for their threads. I've heard about this. Somebody, it's in Woodstock or something. I think they've got a place there. Or anyway, it's beautiful. Hit it.
Yeah, no, so the joint is actually located in town. It's located in Whale Street. I just forgot the address though. Because I haven't been there in a minute. So,
is it Bro Brothers or Broke Brothers?
So at first, when they were still establishing the brand, like they were still trying to establish themselves as a brand, they went by Broke Boys. But up until they got like older and stuff, so they thought, you know what, let's take away the boys now, because we grown men now, you know what I'm saying? And doing amazing things, man. Like, so they go by Broke at this point.
Oh, it's funny, I actually ran into somebody who is from a later generation the other day at the Sea Point Pools Pavilion, and they were like, yeah, have you heard about these Broke Boys? Yeah, I was like, oh, no, I haven't. And I was trying to find it, but there you go, everything lines up. Good to hear.
Yeah, absolutely, man. Yeah, no, shout out to Insert Points for the share, man. Fuck, yeah, we need more of these, bro.
Got some underlings making beats as well, so yeah, spreading the love.
So this one belongs to a guy by the name of Umakalanjalo. He's a Kwaito artist as well, a modern day Kwaito artist, that is. This instrumental is actually from his latest single called Please Call Me. I'd recommend you guys go check it out. It's quite a tune.
Cool. I'll stop talking. Let's hear some more music.
That was Zulu. That was in Zulu. So it is a language predominantly spoken by people from the KZN region up to Gauteng, like Johannesburg side. Yeah.
Beautiful. Cool. So it's still regional. It's still sort of it sort of keeps within the bounds of South Africa, or does it go a little bit more?
Very much local. Very much local. Yeah.
Oh, beautiful. Seems like that's what a lot of the tracks that have been played at the clubs is speaking that language.
Right.
But yeah, it's cool. Everybody, when I was at the club the other day, everyone knew the lyrics to all the songs, but then all of a sudden there'll be this one song that they play and there's only this like cluster of like six or seven people that are singing it. You're like, oh, this must be the song which is in a different language.
Right, yeah, no. Yeah, that happens quite frequently in South Africa, like this part of the world especially.
Beautiful, cool.
I mean, we were blessed with like 11 authentic languages, bro. So, like, I mean, where else could you find that in the world? Like, well, what country has, like, 11 languages? As a matter of fact, I think it's 12 now, if I'm not mistaken. I think they added sign language as an official language as well, which is pretty dope. Like, I love it for I lost my train of thought there.
Love it for the sound. I mean, I'm guessing you love it for the sound, yeah? Like, if you love the language.
No, I was referring to the people who speak in sign language, basically. Like, for it to be considered an official language is, like, it goes to show that we as a country in South Africa, like, we are, like, actually moving forward with the times, you know? And we're not putting aside anyone, you know?
So progressive. Politically at the moment, it's making some amazing stands internationally on a political stage, which is so massive coming from a country which, I mean, it's like, it's just beautiful. It's great to see so many people need to be making a stand like this country is. And, you know, the integration here is actually, it's beautiful, man. Like, people are working alongside from all backgrounds and very globally aware as well. It's good to see. It's been a pleasure traveling here.
Yeah, no, thank you for being here, man. Thank you for pulling through, man. Also, just to add, going back to the guys at Broke, there's a t-shirt that they released sometime last year, which was a print of Broke, right? But then it was in sign language, basically. So you had, like, different signs for like different letters of Broke, you know, which was basically like, you know, paying homage to people who speak in sign language and stuff, which I really commend. Like, I props to the Broke boys, man. Props to you guys. Nah, I really fuck with that tea. I need to get myself that tea, as a matter of fact. Please bring it back.
Right, awesome. I've also been observing some gender equality issues being talked about. Yeah, it's just nice to see. So, yeah, cool. Roll on with this one. Cool. Okay, so where are we at?
Right now we are at Mashamplana. Banket, basically. Banket, which translates to they got me.
Now, we're obviously not on the mid-tempo anymore. We're on the classic Kwaito.
Yeah, very much. So we are at the epitome of Kwaito while it was at its peak, you know. Kwaito was at the forefront of literally everything and everything that's related to South African culture.
Okay, 1980s, so 1990s?
This was predominantly in the early 90s, like you're from 1990 up until like early 2000s, basically.
How do you get recognized as a Kwaito artist? Do you put stuff on YouTube? I mean, this would have been before YouTube, before the internet. Like, how do you get famous?
Yeah, this was way beyond the digital world at the time. Most of the Kwaito artists had like vinyl press ons. They had cassettes. They had. They would also get like airwaves as well, like from radio stations and so forth. Like, especially if they really like am I allowed to curse here?
No, say where you got it, bro.
Especially if they like fuck with the sound and like who you are as an artist, like they definitely gonna like make it a point that they put you on the airwaves and stuff, so like you can make the rotations around the country.
Cool, and I hate to be shallow, but like, did these guys make cash doing this, or was it just a struggle and they were just doing it for love, or?
Hey man, at the time, I feel like, most artists were struggling at the time, but obviously, like, depending on, like, what the agreement is with their recording labels and stuff, in terms of, like, units being sold, they would definitely sell in, like, hotcakes, bro. I can pretty much tell you.
Nice, good to hear. I'm glad they got remunerated, you know?
I mean, they have to, bro. It's part of their craft, you know. It's what belongs to them, essentially, you know. So they're bound to get what's theirs at the end of the day, you know.
Nice. Okay, let's keep going. It's quite a sound. This one, this is nice. So I guess this is the end of the show, pretty much.
Yeah, very much so. Yeah, I know, it was such a hell of an experience, man. Like, shout out to you, Jamie. Thank you so much for giving me per se like such a platform, you know, so I could like just do it for the masses, you know. So yeah, if you are tuned in, Yeah, this one was for you, yeah. Like, this one was for, like, anyone and everyone who wants to be a part of this, you know? Yeah, this one's it.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for coming up, Doc Teller. It's been a pleasure. I told everyone you had a warm heart and beautiful sounds, and I think you fulfilled 100%. So, shout outs, and next time I'm in SA, bro, you know I'll be here.
Yeah, no, definitely looking forward to it, man. Nah, no. Jamie, bro, like, I told you this, like, from the first day we linked up, bro. Like, fuck, nah, dude. Like, fuck to the energy, man. Like, your energy is, like, yo, it's more than I could ask for, man. Like, thank you so much, man. Thank you for the warm welcome, and, you know, I thoroughly had such a great time. What you're doing here, man, is such an amazing thing, man. Like, also, like, it's for music. Like, those who love music in general, whether you are a DJ, a musical producer, or just a listener, so to speak, you know, this one's for you. Like, this right here is for you, man.
Beautiful. Cool. Thanks for listening.
Shout out to Fleet FM. Shout out to you guys. Thank you so much. Dogatella signing out. Yeah!